So first off, just, you know, introduce yourselves, who you are, what your DJ name is.
Sure. Yeah, I'm Ryan Clover. My DJ name is also Ryan Clover. I had a couple of weird ones before that, but I switched. Yeah.
Fabian Castro. I go by Fabi Jugo. I just chose that because I really like juice. It kind of flowed, so that's how I got started.
What's your favorite juice?
Mango, hands down. Hands down.
Yeah, so I've been a piano player for my whole life, since I was a little kid, and I was not into DJing. I really didn't even like house music. And when I came to New York, met Fabian, we ended up living together, and he was DJing, so I slowly became interested, and then became a house head very quickly, so, yeah.
Yeah, I semi off and on played instruments, but never seriously, and then in college, basically, was running a lot for soccer I played, and was like, I wanted a good mix to run to, and everyone else has sucked, so I just kind of taught myself to mix like that, and then DJed a few parties in college, and then just didn't really even consider doing anything with, you know, outside of that. And then when we moved in together, you know, he's very much the type to get headstrong, so he got me excited, and then from there we started doing parties, and it's been just a lot of fun and growing from there.
Fania itself just represents to me at least, the freedom of sound. When you're digging through catalogs, whether it's disco or salsa, where people are playing live instruments, it's so much different than, you know, what I myself make in studio. It's a lot more natural. It feels more human. When there are these old songs that have been created by multiple human beings in one space.
Yeah, definitely. It goes ahead and behind the rhythm. There's, you know, syncopation. Like, we listen so much electronic music. It's computer, it's on a grid, and it doesn't feel like it's live. And Fania, you know, on top of being live, it just always has that natural rhythm. Like, whatever it may be, whether it's the lulu, the funk, the soul, it's always driving. It's always energy. Even if it's a song about heartbreak, right, it's still inspiring you to go out there again, I guess.
And I think it's talked about a lot in the scene, especially in house and techno, that, you know, people are coming in aren't paying enough respect to how it was, or how the music started, or, you know, how it became so huge. Especially in New York, where, you know, disco birthed house, right? Disco is New York sound, right? So it's a similar process here. So I think it's really awesome that you guys are really trying to integrate the old world into the new world. We're proud to be a part of that.
I mean, in a sense,
not the old world.
Yeah, in a sense, it's almost like now parties. There's almost like a gentrification of parties, and like when we first started getting into DJing and throwing parties and stuff like that, is what we really noticed. Like watching documentaries on old house venues, Paradise Garage, and stuff like that, is those were places where everyone from every part of the city came under one roof, right? Like, you know, you had drag queens, and you had the Latinos, and you had the whites, and it was just like, it all came together, and there was no level of pretentiousness or nothing about, you know, material wealth. It was strictly there for the enjoyment of the music, and so I think that's what Armada Fania is all about, right? Is like, people will come because they know they're going to hear good music, and they know they're going to dance. There's no facade. It's just all people being present and, you know, loving the music, so.